A tutto aprire.
Ok.
Okay, can you start?
Om Agyana Diviram Drashavya Nanyana Salapaya Chakshumi Tanjena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namo Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhika Vetadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadbhaktaya Namo Namo Vanchakalodrasya Kripa Sindhu Vayevacha Satitanang Pavanepu Vaishnave Punamo Namo Mahavadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitana Namne Gaurati Seno E Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopisa Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Tattakanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavane Sare Visavanusate Devi Pranamami Hari Prem Om Vrindavai Tulasi Devai Priyavai Kesavashacha Krishna Bhakti Prade Devi Sattavatri Namona Bhakta Vihina Aparadha Lakshai Kiptascha Kamadi Tarangamadhai Kripa Maitang Saranam Prapanna Vrindhi Namaste Charana Arvindam Bhajami Radhang Arvinda Netrang Smarami Radhang Madhura Smitashram Vadami Radhang Karuna Varadra Tatumannasti Gathirna Kapi Ha Devi Kakuvara Gadagada Yadvacha Jachini Patti Bhuvi Dandava Durvudarti Asya Prasadma Vadasya Janasya Krutva Gandharvike Nijagane Gananam Vidhe Angasamulavi Chata Mandi Kitendri Varang Jaddam Jaju Guru Ruchisang Pattam Parasasriyam Bindaru Nivasam Nidhila Saddam Adidamudaram Radha Skandani Vesalo Jalovijam Dhyam Sudamudaram tavai vasmi najibami tabina ite vigyaya te radhe tanganayami charanantike Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nittananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Shri Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So first of all, I offer my humble respectful obeisances unto lotus feet of my Gurupad Padma Nittarila Pravishtam Vishnupad Ashtutra Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Silavaman Goswami Maharaj and Nittarila Pravishtam Vishnupad Ashtutra Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Silavaman Goswami Maharaj. Simultaneously, I offer my humble respectful Dandavat Pranam Lotus Feet of Nittalila Pravishtam Vishnupad Ashtutara Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Sila Gurunda Sri Maharaj Sila Bhakti Rakha Siddhar Goswami Maharaj and all senior devotees and all Vaishnava Vaishnavis and present all of my respectful guests. Such a long time I did not give Skype class about Brihad Bhagavatam Ritam. Now again I am thinking to give Skype class about Brihad Bhagavatam Ritam. 3 months before I also gave class Brihad Bhagavatam Ritam in Skype, and I told in Brihad Bhagavatam Ritam Sanatana Goswami Pad very nicely and elaborately discussed about the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. Because Srimad Bhagavatam actually very complicated to understand. There are many Tattva Siddhanta, so many concepts of the scriptures, and not so easy to understand. For this regard, Sanatana Goswami Pad very nicely and elaborately discuss about the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam in his unprecedented book, Brihad Bhagavatam Amritam. Sanatana Goswami Pad in this Brihad Bhagavatam Amritam, he also explained two things. One, the story of Narad Rishi, or another story of Gopa Kumar. Because according to the requirement of Mother Uttara, those who are doing bhajan and sadhan, say, so after their bhajan and sadhan matured, where will go there? That time Parikshit Maharaj told his mother Uttara, actually all different the devotees according to their mood, they will attain the highest planet of transcendental world. Everybody will not go to the Vaikuntha, everybody will not go Ayodhya, Dwaraka, Mathura and Kula Vrindavan. All the jivas, they will be attained to transcendental world according to their potential activities of jivas, jivatma sarup. According to the sarup of jivatma, soul, they will be attained the different transcendental places such as Vaikuntha, Ayodhya, Dwaraka, Mathura, then Golok and Vrindavan. So in this way, Sanatana Goswami Pad very nicely explained about Narad Rishi's katha. Narad Rishi also met with different devotees and different places, and he glorified to their bhakti. And they also very humble told, oh, they are not the pure devotee of Lord. This is their humility. Or another story of Gopkumar, he did bhajan and sadhan and chanted Gopal mantra. Then he attained also in Sargaloka and he became the king of heaven Indra, but he was not satisfied in the position of Indra. Then he also came in Janaloka, Tapaloka and Satyaloka. Then Indra, he also became Brahma in Satyaloka, Brahmaloka. This katha also I explained in my last Harikatha. Ye Brahmaji, he is the very nearest and dearest of Krishna. This is true, because Brahmaji, he creates this material world. Then Brahmaji, he is called Krishna's Gunavatar, three Gunavatars of Lord Krishna. That is called Satya, Raja and Tamaguna. Tamaguna avatar, incarnation of Lord Tamaguna, that is called Lord Shivji, who destroys this material world. Dhamsa, Karak, he destroys the material world. Satyaguna avatar, incarnation of mood of goodness. Satyaguna avatar, that is called Lord Vishnu, who nourishments all the living entities in this universe. Or Rajaguna avatar, Brahmaji, with the creators of this material world. So Brahmaji, what is his name? Gopkumar, he arrived in Sataloka. And he saw how Lord Brahma, how worship his Ishtadev source Sisra, Vishnu. One day I told, Brahmaji's Ishtadev, that is called Sahasra Sirsa Vishnu. And Brahmaji, every day he performed fire sacrifice, then Sahasra Sirsa Vishnu appeared from the Jagna of Brahmaji and direct he gives blessing to him. And also Sahasra Sirsa Vishnu asked in his all kinds of good and evil things way. And if he has any problem, our Lord also solves all his problems. This katha we also heard. Gop Kumar, when he arrived, then he noticed how Lord Sahasra Sirsa Vishnu Bhagavan so much love and affection with Brahmaji. Because Brahmaji is the son of Lord also, Bhagavat Putra. Because Brahmaji manifested from the lotus navels of Lord. Bhagavan ke Navi Kamal se Brahmaji prakat huye. Brahmaji manifested from the lotus navels of Lord. Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadev Goswami Pad very nicely also explained this katha. And when Brahma appeared, then he saw the everywhere completely full of water and big ocean, big waves. And then Brahmaji could not understand where he has come from. Brahmaji just he saw himself, he's sitting on the lotus, or around the lotus, all full of water. Then Brahmaji thinking, why have I come here? Why Lord manifested me? What is my duty? Then Brahmaji, mind very disturbed. Then Brahmaji thinking, where I have come from? Then Brahmaji, he hold the lotus stamp, Navi Kamal Danda, and he also trying down, where is this stamp of lotus? But Brahmaji could not find out. Again, Brahmaji, he returned back his own place on the on the lotus. Then he thinking, what will do now? That time just sound coming from the lotus, top. Topo, in Sanskrit word, to and po, there's two syllables. Then Brahmaji realized, oh Lord, once to me, I have to perform austerities, penances, tapasya. Then Brahmaji, he performed tapasya. Then Lord manifested in his heart and told, hey Brahmaji, you have to create this material world. Because you have Rajaguna, mode of you have Rajaguna, so you have to create. So Brahmaji, he is called the creator of this material world, Srishtikarta Brahma. But if you have any problems, then Brahmaji meditate to Lord, then Lord direct appear and also solve all his problems. Gop Kumar, he noticed how Brahma, she has so much love and affection with Lord Sahasra Sirsa Vishnu. Then Brahmaji, then Gop Kumar just is thinking, if I would become Brahma this place, then I can also direct talk with Lord and I will serve to him more and more. In this way, Gop Kumar, just he was thinking and chanting this mantra, and Gopal mantra, and also chanting the mantra, Sri Krishna Gopala Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishora Krishna Ha Sri Yashoda Tanaya Prasida Sri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhikesa Sri Krishna Gopala Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Ha Sri Yashoda Tanaya Prasida Sri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhikesa Sri Krishna Gopala Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Ha Sri Yashoda Tanaya Prasida Sri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhikesa. In this way, Gop Kumar, he chanted this Maha Mantra. This Mahantra composed by Srila Sanatana Goswami Pad. And also Gop Kumar, he was chanting Gopal Mantra. That's called, now is called Krishna Mantra, Gopal Mantra. And Gop Kumar just is think, just he, his desire is coming, I want to become Brahma. And mantra is very powerful, Naam and Mantra is very powerful. Naam and Mantra fulfill all your desires. Nama Chintamani Krishna Chaitana Rasavigraha Purna Suddha Nitya Mukto Abhinna Tvat Nama Namina. Nama Chintamani, holy names is called Chintamani. Chintamani is desire stone. Desire stone means if you if your any desire will come, and then all you do fulfilled by Lord. So holy name is called also Nama Chintamani. Holy name is called the desire stone. Naam mantra is very powerful. So when Gop Kumar, he was chanting this Naam and mantra, Gopal mantra, and this Mahamantra is Krishna, Gopal, Hari, Mukunda. Then Brahmaji, his job completely finished. Jogmasi arranged in this way. Then Brahmaji, he liberated and left that the place. Then Gop Kumar, he also, and now Gop Kumar, he is the now he is taking the place of Brahmaji, and he takes charge all the responsibilities of Brahmaji. Because Gop Kumar, this desire coming, I want to take charge the position of Brahma. Then Gop Kumar is very happy in Satya Lokas, and he worship to Lord Sastasesa Vishnu very nicely. Sometimes Gop Kumar's mind little bit disturbed. Because if you have highest post, then you have also many duty and responsibilities. And every time, every second, all the demigod and demigodies, they used to come in Satya Loka, and they saying, "Hey, Brahma Pitamaha, Father, Grandfather, and we are in many dangerous, many problems are coming, this. So Gop Kumar, his mind also disturbed these things. Oh, why did I take the charge of Brahmaji? Very difficult to bhajan and sadhan. If I would not take charge, if I would not take charge the position of Brahma, I can do bhajan and sadhan. Now I have no, now I am engaged to solve all the problems of demigodies. And Brahmaji's duty, these things, when all the demigodies, they pray to Lord Brahma for their any problems, then Brahma have to go the way of Kirut Sahib Vishnu and paying to lotus feet of Lord Vishnu. And these things also Sukhdev Goswami Pad explained Srimad Bhagavatam, when the demon disturbs all the devotees of this material world, and demon committed many sinful activities, then Prithvi Devi could not tolerate the sinful activities of demon. Then Prithvi Devi, the presiding deities of earth, Prithvi Devi manifested in the form of cow, Gomata, and she came in heavenly planet Sargoloka and prayed to all the demigod demigodies how to help to her. Then king of heaven Sargoloka, Raja, king of heaven Sargoloka Indra, he also came in Brahmaloka, Saptaloka and prayed to Lord Brahma how to solve all the problems of Prithvi Devi. Then Brahmaji, he prayed to lotus feet of Lord Vishnu. When that time Vishnu, he was taking rest, and his consort Lakshmi Devi, she was massaging his lotus feet. In that same time, Brahma, all the demigods headed by Brahma, they prayed to Lord Vishnu. Hey Lord Vishnu, please help to Prithvi Devi. Then Lord Vishnu just opened his eyes and smiled. And Lord Vishnu took out the two hair from his head. One is that is called white, and another is called black. That means Lord Vishnu told if Brahma and all the demigods don't worry, within few days my master and Vajranandana Samsandar, he will be appear in this material world and will solve all your problems. Here Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad explained, when Lord Vishnu pulled out one white hair and another with a blackish hair, that means the significance is that the successor of Vishnu's supreme master, that is called Vajranandana Samsandar, for this regard, here and Sushil Vishnu pulled out the two hair. One is called white and another is called black. That means Krishna and Balaram. Black hair is the personification of Krishna, and white hair is the personification of Baladev Prabhu. That means in this way, Lord Vishnu assured to Brahma Ji and all the demigods, don't worry. Your master Vajranandana Samsundar and his brother Baladev Prabhu soon appear in this material world and solve all your problems. So in this way, then Gop Kumar, he is thinking, oh, now I am Brahma and I am taking charge. I am taking the position of Brahma, but so much busy, so many activities. Do this way. Then one day, Brahmaji, that means Gop Kumar, is thinking, what will do now? Then Brahmaji, that means Gop Kumar, he also calls to all the Ved, Puran, Upanishad, and discuss about their own experience. And one big assembly house in Brahmaloka, Sattvaloka, Gop Kumar, he called all the presiding deities of Ved, Puran, Upanishad. All they came manifest in the form Chandogya Upanishad, Taittiriya Upanishad, and Ved, Puran, Upanishad. All they also manifested the form of very nice, beautiful form, as like Devata form. And in the assembly house, also Srimad Bhagavatam came, the presiding deities of Srimad Bhagavatam is there. And in the assembly house, then Gop Kumar, he came, and all the presiding deities of Upanishad, Ved, Puran, Prasanna, they gave perfect respect to Gop Kumar. Then Gop Kumar, very humble, he also paid his obeisances to all the presiding deities of Ved, Puran, Upanishad. Rig, Sam, Yaju, Atharva, and also Puranas, Upanishads in their big assembly house in that place. Gop Kumar, just he asked to them, what is their realization, then anubhuti kya hai? That time, everybody, they quoted their slokas from their shastra. And Vedas explained the my experience is the Brahma is the supreme. And Athatu Brahma Jiggasa. And Shastra Janitvat Tattu Samanyat. And the in this way, Vedas also explain Brahma is the supreme. And everybody should inquire about Brahma. Upanishad also explain about Paramatma, Super Soul, and Kata, Keno, Chandogya, Taittiriya, all Upanishad, they also discuss about Lord and spirituality, Bhagavata. Badan Tata Vidastatam, Jaj Ganamadam, Brahmati, Paramatmi, Bhagavaniti, Sabdati, in this way, Ved, Puran, Upanishad, they also explain their own realization. But last Gop Kumar asked about Srimad Bhagavatam, who is the presiding deity of Srimad Bhagavatam. What is your opinion? What is your realization? And that time Srimad Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, that means the presiding deity of Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavat ke Adhishthatri Devatas, very humble, he told, I am listening to all the opinion of Ved Puran Upanishad, because Ved Puran Upanishad, some they glorified about Brahma, some they glorified Paramatma, some they glorified Yoga, Gyan, Tapasya in this way, for this regard. The president deities of Srimad Bhagavatam, he also, I am very happy to listen their own realization. But I want to speak about my own realization. Gop Kumar, he very humble, asks to the president deities of Srimad Bhagavatam, what is your opinion? Then Srimad Bhagavatam glorified his own activities, Nigama Kalpatar Galita Falam, Sukam Khad, Mutadrava Samjutam, Pibata Bhagavata Rasamalam, Muraho Rosika, Bhogi Bhavuka. The present deities of Srimad Bhagavatam told, what is Srimad Bhagavatam? Srimad Bhagavatam, Nigama Kalpatar Galita Falam. Srimad Bhagavatam is called the sweet ripened fruits of Veda Kalpa Vriksha. That means Veda is called the Kalpa Vriksha, desert tree, and that desert tree's fruits, that is called Srimad Bhagavatam. For this regard, Srimad Bhagavatam, third verse, very clearly explained in this way, Negama Kalpataru Galita Phalam Sukha Mukhad Amrita Drava Samjutam Pivata Bhagavata Rasamalayam Muhuroho Rasika Bhuvi Bhavuka. The Rasik and Bhavuk devotee, every second, every moment, they are releasing the sweet nectar, Amrit Asadankal. Because Srimad Bhagavatam, that is called evidence of all the scriptures. Dharma Prajita Kaito Vatra Parma Nirmat Sana Satang Vidvasma Tapatra Unumulam Srimad Bhagavatam Mahamani Kriti Kingba Parishra Isara Saddu Hridda Avruddhati Kritivi Susruvi Tatkhanat, Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, and second slokas also. Srimad Bhagavatam, that is called the spotless Puran. In this spotless Puran, and direct talked about bhakti. And Srimad Bhagavatam cut the all the philosophy of karma, jnana, and yoga. And tapasya. Krishna also told to Uddhava these things. No sasri mang yoga, no sankadharma, na sankadharma sadhya tapastu na salti mang yoga. Krishna told, by the performance of karma, gyan, yoga, tapasya, anyone attend to me. Na saditu mang yoga, na sankatama uddhava, na saddhas tapastyago jatha bhaktirva maurjita. Only the performing the bhakti devotion service to Lord, then devotee can attain to Lord. Then karma, gyan, yoga, tapasya, by the performing karma, gyana, yoga, tapasya, and pronunciation, then cannot properly attain to Lord. Only bhakti yoga, manasa samukha praniti amali apashat purushang purna mayancha tadapasaram. Vyasadeva also he told his own realization. Yeah, by the performing of bhakti yoga, how Vyasadeva he direct took darshan the lotus feet of Krishna and he saw Maya, the illusory potency of Lord, the external potency of Lord, how Maya is far from Krishna. Jaha Krishna taha nahi, Maya adhikar. Where is Krishna? There is no Maya. So, in this way, Srimad Bhagavatam gives evidence, dharma prajjitu koituva atra paraman manmasanasatam taputra unmulam. And if you read Srimad Bhagavatam, then all your tapu, then adhyantik, adhidaivik and adhibhautik, three tapas, then will be removed from your heart. And you attain to Shuddha Bhakti. Then best if you realize this thing. Sabai pungsan paro dharma jato bhakti adhas khoje ahituki apratiyata jatma samprasidati. Then this is the activities of Srimad Bhagavatam. Then one who performs Shuddha Bhakti, you attain to transcendental world. Then Bhakti Reva Nayati, Bhakti Reva Dasati, Bhakti Vasa Purusha. Our Upanishad also explained Bhakti Reva Nayati, Bhakti brings to the devotee very close to Lord. Bhakti karne se bhakti Bhagavan ki hoti nikat mein aa jata hai. Bhakti reva nayati, bhakti reva darshayati. If you are bhakti doing service to Lord, then you can direct to see His beautiful form, Bhagavat form. Jyotir Abhantari, Dibhujo Muralidhara, Shyama Sundara. Krishna, He remains in the middle of effulgence and of Lord. So also our scriptures explain in this way, one who performs bhakti, he can direct attend to Lord. So bhakti reva nayati, bhakti reva darsati, bhakti vasa, and Lord completely also bounded by bhakti. Bhakti ke dara Bhagavan ko vasivut kiya jata hai. And if you want to control to Lord, you have to practice Shuddha Bhakti. And so in this way, Vedas, Puranas, Upanishad, and Srimad Bhagavatam glorifies about bhakti. Without bhakti, life is also useless. And Tulsidas also explained in Banyan, in Namak Bina Banyan Jash. If you cooked many kinds of and subjects and preparation, but if you forget to put the salt in there, the and vegetables which you cooked, that is called useless. In the same way, if you perform all the rules and regulations of the society, following all the scriptures, this is true, but if you would not to practice bhakti, all your endeavors, that is called useless. And that means proof is that bhakti is very prominent. Without bhakti, no one can deliver from this or from this material also. Karma, gyan, yog cannot give the fruit without bhakti. And bhakti not depend on any karma, gyan, yog and tapasya. Bhakti that is called satantra, independence. Bhakti satantra, satantra. Karma, gyan, yog, they are not satantra, independence. Karma and gyan will give the fruits when devotee completely surrender to lotus feet of Lord, and that time Lord will give mercy. So in this way, Srimad Bhagavatam glorified about bhakti, and others Puranas they glorified karma, jnana, yoga, and tapasya. And specially Lord completely controlled by Shuddha Bhakti. Anna Abhilashita Sunna Jnana Karmadana Britam Anukulina Krishnanu Silam Bhaktira Uttama. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad very nicely and composed this verse about Shuddha Bhakti. And so in this way, Srimad Bhagavatam also gives evidence. The presiding deities of Srimad Bhagavatam glorified about bhakti. And especially in this Kali Yuga, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu give us this instruction, Shuddha Bhakti, that is called Naam Sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. In this Kali Yuga, perfect Shuddha Bhakti that is called Naam Sankirtan. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu glorified about Naam Sankirtan. Cheto Darpana Marjanam, Bhava Maha, Davag Nirbapanam, Sreya Kairva Chandrika, Bitaranam, Vidabudhi Jeevanam, Anandam Madhi Vardam, Patipadam, Pranamrita Sadhanam, Sarva Atma Sanapati. Sarva Atma Sanapanam Param Vijayate Shri Krishna Sankirtanam. In this Kali Yuga, Naam Sankirtan is very powerful. Renouncing, chanting of the holy names, and then all anarth is removed from our heart, anartha nirmukti. Then, and step by step, we attain Shuddha Bhakti. So, Naam Sankirtan, that is called the perfect Shuddha Bhakti. Kalikale nam bina ar nahi dharma. Sarva shastir ei koila sar marma. Vrindavan Das to Chaitanya Bhagavat also explain, in this Kali Yuga, there are many other process and to attend to Lord. Only Shuddha Bhakti, their devotion service to Lord. Then, though Srimad Bhagavatam glorified about nine types of bhakti, Sarvanam Kirtan, Vishnu Smaran, Pada, Sivanam, Achanabandam, Dasa, Sakatma, Nividanam, Iti Pungsar Vita Vishnu Bhakti Chet Navalakshana. But topmost bhakti Katarma the Sarva Sistra Nam Sankirtan Niro Aparadhi Nam Raili Krishna Pai Premadhan. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami also glorified about bhakti. Though there are many kinds of limbs of bhakti, bhakti kyanga, but nine limbs of bhakti are prominent. But among these nine limbs of bhakti, sadha sadhu sangha bhajan kya anarthi nishtha ruchi asakti bhav prem. This is the process how to attain our perfection goal. So sravanakya bhakti, kirtanakya bhakti, smaranakya bhakti, sravan, sravanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam pada sivanam archan bandhan dasva sakha atma nivedanam. These are called the nine limbs of bhakti. But in Chaitanya Chaitanya Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami also explained, and five types of bhakti also, sadhu sangha, nam sankirtan, mutrabas, simurti shraddha, sevan, sakal sadhan sesto, e panchir mukhanga, krishna prem janmai, panchir alpa sangha. Chaitanya Chaitanya Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami also explained in the five types of shuddha bhakti, that's called sadhu sangha, nam sankirtan, and Mutravas, Srimurti, Shraddhai, Sevan. Worship the deities with firm faith. So Sadhu Sangha, Nam Sankirtan, Bhagavat Sravan, Mutravas, Srimurti, Shraddhai, Sevan. But at Kali Yuga, sometimes you are not possible to these five types of bhakti. Then also Kali Yuga give more concession. What they concession? The Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Masmaranam. Therefore, in this Kali Yuga, also very difficult to Sravan Kirtan. So, what to do? Tarma the Sarvashishta, Nam Sankirtan. Among all these bhakti, Nam Sankirtan is the topmost. And one who chants holy names without offense, Nirapad Harinam, then you attain to Lord. So, in this way, in the assembly house of Brahma, Sattvaloka, Gokumar, he listened and all the Tattva Siddhanta from the different presiding deities of Shastra. Shastra ki all and sab sunne lage. Then Gopkumar, he realized bhakti is the topmost. And one who practices bhakti, then you attain to above to Lord. Yatpada pankaja palasa vilasa bhakta karmasam gathitam udgrathayanti santa tadvanno riktamatayu jatayu niruddha srota ganastam aranam bhajavasudevam. Sukhdev Goswami Pad told to Parikshit Maharaj, how is powerful Nam Sankirtan and Harinam and Suddha Bhakti. Yogis, they perform the many kinds of yoga and tapasya, they will be fall down. Ganis, they will be fall down. But those who are devotees of Lord Vishnu, they will never fall down. In this verse, very clear, Jat Pad Pankaja Pilas Palasa Vilasa Bhakta Karmasam Gatham Udgatayanti Santa Tadvanno Riktamatayo Jatayo Niruddha Suta Ganastam Aranam Vrajavasudeva. One who performs Suddha Bhakti to Lord Vishnu, then automatically all his sinful act will automatically destroy. Then, Tabe hai karmanda mukti, tabe se huite bari Sri Krishna and Das. Then, because if you chant holy names, all you unearth removes from his heart. Then automatically become the maidservant Srimati Radhika. So saying, agraha mukti tabe karmanda nas, tabe se huite bari Sri Krishna Das. And so this Das, this was very confidential also. Alpayanam haniyo Krishna Das nam, Alpavagya nam nahi karen Bhagavan. And don't worry this sweet words about servant. But Lord will accept his servant, those who are very nearest dense Lord and those who have faith, Suddha Bhakti to Lord. In this way, Srimad Bhagavatam, Ved, Puran, Upanishad, everywhere glorifies about Suddha Bhakti. Just I told Bhakti Reva Nayati, Bhakti Reva Darsati, Bhakti Vasa Purusha. Bhakti Reva Nayati, Bhakti brings the living entities towards Lord. Bhakti Reva Nayati, Bhakti Reva Darsati, by the rendering practice of Suddha Bhakti, and then you attain to Lord also. Bhakti Reva Darsati, and you, by the performing of Suddha Bhakti, you can direct contact with Lord, and direct you can see the beautiful form of Lord. Balavindavan Vihari Lal Ki Jai. In this way, in the assembly house of Gopkumar, and Gopkumar, we attentively listen and all the conversation of Ved, Puran, Upanishad, and Srimad Bhagavatam. Then Gopkumar, he concluded his own opinion of Suddha Bhakti is the topmost. And so, in this way, Sanatana Goswami Pad, Brihad Bhagavatamritam, in the story of Gopkumar and the story of the consort of Lord Vishnu, or they are called Lord Vishnu's consort and Lakshmi's. And when they heard this katha, their heart melted. And maybe next time we'll discuss more how Brahmaji, Gopkumar, he's thinking, I have to go to Vaikuntha. And then on the way of Vaikuntha, Lord Shiva and Parvati met with him. Then Lord Shiva and Parvati glorified about Janalok and other planets, and also glorified about Suddha Bhakti. Bolo Shri Gurudev ki jai. Jai Jai Sri Radhesh Gur Premanandi Hari Hari. Thank you.